Shirazi, is it?
Yes.
Fine.
Through here, please.
Did you see what happened?
No.
Miss Laws, I'm PC Quinn and this is WPC Keane. You say you were attacked?
Yes. Well, not really.
What happened?
I'd just come out of the tube station up the road. Well, I was walking down this way and there was a young man behind me. I got the feeling he was following me. I turned to look at him and he opened his jacket. Well, I could see he had a knife. Well, then he just said, run.
Just that?
Yeah, just quietly so no one else could hear.
What did you do?
Well, I did what he said. I ran.
And he chased you?
Yeah. But then just when I thought he was going to catch me, he seemed to drop back. Well, then I got here and ran in.
Right, excuse me. Mr. Shirazi, did you see this man?
From a distance, yes. I went into the street and we saw him running away.
What, back up towards the tube?
Yes.
And what did he look like?
A white teenager, about my height. He had a black cap on and a dark jacket with some sort of a design on the back.
Are you driving the van?
Yeah.
Would you like to tell me what happened?
Your car's parked outside my own house, yeah, and he comes along and smashes right into
this
it.
This kid's just run out in front of me. I was coming down the road and he's run out of the motor there. If I hadn't have swerved, I'd have killed him.
And where is he now?
He ran off that way.
Did you see the boy?
Well, no, I was in my house.
There was a fight going on.
Fight?
Yeah, over there, a load of kids. That's what he was running from.
He looks so normal, not the threatening type at all.
From what you say, it sounds like he deliberately showed you the knife.
He opened his jacket on purpose so I could see it.
What sort of knife was it?
A butcher's knife. With a red plastic handle. It was like it was some sick game he was playing, only he wasn't laughing.
Three street robberies, one suspect. I don't believe it. Come again. Dark jacket, black baseball cap. Same MO each time. And then about half an hour ago, a youth answering to the same description pulls a knife on a woman outside a tube station. You reckon it's the same one? Well, sounds like it. Except he tells her to run, lest her get away.
He could be one of those we've already nicked, filling in time before his trial.
Nah, doesn't sound like one of our regulars. I mean, why would he warn his victim? It's crazy.
Well, it's down here, four lads.
And they were fighting, you say?
Well, one of them grabbed another lad by the throat and they all started punching and kicking him.
So three of them onto the one?
Yeah, that's right.
And he was the one that ran out in front of you?
Well, he went down, they all started kicking him, he broke loose and ran straight out. I mean, it all happened in seconds.
Could you describe him?
I guess he was about 16, 17. He had a dark bomber jacket on and a black baseball cap.
And what about the others?
I think it's such a good look at him. Seen him before, though. They live around here quite a lot.
Well, could you put a name to him?
Nah. I'll tell you something, though. This wasn't just kid stuff. That boy really didn't want to get caught.
Sarge, you know your attempted street robber?
We're just talking about him.
Well, I think he might have cropped up again.
Who's he chasing now?
Well, this time he was the one being chased. There was an RTA on Frithwood Street, and the driver reckons he saw three youths having a go at a fourth. He ran out into the road, that's what caused the accident. Only it sounds like the same youth that was chasing the woman outside the tube station.
I suppose he got away.
Yeah, but the driver's fairly sure that all the boys came from the same school, RV Wallace Comprehensive.
Now, why doesn't that surprise me?
What makes you so sure they're from this school?
Witness seemed to think so.
I know that Harley Wallace has got a reputation, but I'm not aware of any gang activity. This could be just normal kid stuff.
I think it's a bit more serious than that.
I've only been here a few weeks. I'm still putting names to faces. But the consensus in the staff room was that this one sounds like Danny Mitchell.
And he's the one they've been ganging up on?
Which apparently would also make sense.
Is he here now?
No, he's an habitual truant. For the past 6 months or so, according to the records. I've sent for a couple of his friends. We'll see if we can get something out of them.
I'd also like to talk to him about a couple of other incidents.
What kind of incidents?
A couple of street robberies.
Well, that doesn't square with what I've been told about him. Victim, yes. Mugger, no.
Well, the policy of gating alleys like this has been going on for some time now, but this is the first in Sun Hill.
And the impetus comes from the residents.
Well, they approached us and we were able to advise them on the sighting of the gate. Well, obviously, we can't block off rights of way.
Excuse me, sir. I think he wants you in the photo.
Excuse me.
Of course.
Pardon me. Get the officer.
Hey. So what sort of crime are you targeting with this initiative?
Well, there have been a couple of sexual assaults down here and it's a rat run to the back of the estate. By blocking it off, we might also cut down on burglary.
And you think the effect to be significant?
Well, all the evidence suggests so. Anything which gives residents control of their environment and denies it to criminals has got to be a good thing.
Ah, Steve, come in. This is DS Daly from Sun Hill.
I'm keen to talk to a lad called Danny Mitchell about a couple of incidents that have happened outside school hours. I gather you're a friend of his.
He ain't got any friends. Space Ranger.
You what?
Space Ranger, that's what they call him.
Oh, why do they call him that?
Well, he's plugged into the moon, isn't he? Weird, talks to himself.
Maybe he hasn't got anybody else to talk to.
And you've no idea where he might be?
No.
OK, thanks a lot.
What's he done anyway?
Send Paul in, will you?
Hello, Paul. I'm D.S. Daly from Sun Hill. I'm here about Danny Mitchell. You know anything about what he's been up to lately?
No.
Oh, come on. Everybody tells me that you and him are friends.
Not really. I used to hang around with him a bit, but not anymore.
Why is that?
Danny keeps himself to himself.
Look, Paul, if any of you know where he is or what he's been up to, you're not going to do him any favours by keeping quiet.
I don't.
Well, if you do hear anything, if there's some rumour going round, hope I can at least rely on you to let me know.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thanks, Paul. So what's that? Wall of silence? Or are they telling the truth?
Not the most communicative bunch, are they? I might pick something up on the grapevine.
Lad who just went out.
Paul Gibson.
You seem to think he might come up with something.
Possibly. He's one of the brighter lads, him and his sister. They seem to look to him as a bit of a role model. I reckon he's a good kid. I'm still finding my way around here. Can't claim to have my finger on the pulse yet. But even if something was going on, I might not be aware of it. You see, there's a whole lot of shadow time. On the way to school, on the way home, in the lunch breaks, when they're not in the parents' control, and they're not in ours. And then, who knows what they get up to.
They've got no sanction, have they? Worst thing you can do with a problem kid is expel him.
Then he becomes our problem.
And when I was a...
Yeah, now don't tell me. You were flogged every day.
Get round the back.
Yeah, right.
Mrs. Mitchell?
Yeah?
D.S. Daly, Sun Hill. This is D.C. Lyons.
Well, don't tell me I've been burgled.
No, we're looking for your son, Danny.
Well, he's at school.
He isn't. We've just come from there. Would you mind if we look inside?
Has he been bunking off? Is that what this is all about?
If we can just look.
I told you he wouldn't be here.
Mind if we look upstairs?
It's a waste of time. Danny! Oh my God! Danny! Call an ambulance! Oh, quick, hurry! Please!
Yeah, D.S. Daly, oh, Sun Hill. Ambulance, please. Suspected
Danny,
overdose.
What have you done?
Right, thanks. They've pumped him out. He's in no danger. It was a pretty incompetent attempt as they go.
Sounds about right. What about his injuries?
Cuts and bruises. Somebody get my right going over. Hang on. Hello.
He's never done anything like this before. Never.
Have you noticed any change in his behaviour lately?
What do you mean?
Well, has he become quiet, moody, withdrawn?
No, oh, he's always like that.
What about friends?
He doesn't seem to have any, really. There was this one boy he brought home a couple of times, but he didn't last.
Who was that?
Paul Gibson.
Anyone else?
No, not really.
Now then, Danny, how are you feeling?
All right.
So what was all that about?
I don't know. I just got fed up.
We all get fed up, son. I don't call that much of an excuse.
What happened to your face? You didn't do that with pills.
It was nothing. Just some kids.
Is that why you've been bunking off school?
Oh, Danny, if there's something wrong, just tell us.
I suppose you knew we wanted to talk to you. Well, whatever the problem is, this isn't the answer.
I just wanted out.
Out of what?
Everything.
Hi, Dave Quinn and Sam Hill, you called?
Yeah, the jewellery shop downstairs had a brooch stolen about 5 minutes ago. And the manager followed the thief out the shop, but when he got outside, he'd lost him. One of my colleagues has gone looking for him. And they've got him on video, but he could be anywhere by now.
Right, did he know that he'd been spotted?
No, I don't think so.
Right, good, good. In that case, he may not be too far away, so...
Hang on. My mate thinks he's seen him at the kiosk downstairs.
Right, okay, I'll take the far staircase, yeah?
He's there.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay, if you hang on here.
Excuse me, sorry. Have a word, please.
How was the Harvey Wallace?
Pleasure. As always.
Got another inmate in custody now.
Oh, really?
Kid nicked for shoplifting. Gibson. Paul Gibson. You know.
The Alligator's Guide. What do you think?
It's a snappy title.
Hi.
Ah, Jane. We've just been looking over your policy document. Jane Allen, the Community Safety Officer. This is Inspector Munro.
We meet at last.
Oh, I'm sorry I couldn't be there this morning, but I gather it all went smoothly.
Yes, there was a fair bit of press interest.
Good, that's what we want.
I asked Andrew along because I thought it'd be good to have a view from the sharp end.
Absolutely.
So, what can we do for you?
Well, as you know, we're strongly committed to this gating policy. But obviously, it's got to be a partnership between yourselves and us. We've identified about 20 sites, alleys and lanes behind terraces, that would benefit from having gates installed.
Well, I'm sure we could find 20 more.
At least.
Good, that's what I want.
You're not serious.
Certainly, why not?
Well, in my experience, a policy like that needs three things. Money, money, and more money.
Well, of course, money's always a problem. But it's not your problem.
Nevertheless, I'm curious. How are you going to fund it?
Money matching. If residents are willing to raise part of the money themselves, then the council will match it, up to 50% of the total cost.
That's still quite a bill.
Yeah, but we've studied schemes like this in other boroughs and we're convinced of the benefits. Well, quite apart from anything else, the very process of raising the money brings the community together.
It's certainly seen that way.
Well, I'll get on to the crime prevention officer. Andrew, have a word with the relief, will you? See how they respond.
Yes, sir.
And we'll, get back to you with some suggestions.
Sounds good.
Talking of crime prevention, how about a wall around the Cockcroft estate?
Computer games. Old ones I don't use much.
How do you get the new ones?
I bought them. I saved up. That's just pocket money.
Okay, let's go. I searched his room myself a couple of weeks ago. He was acting strange. I thought it might be drugs. I went down to your station and got some leaflets and had a good look round when he was out. I didn't find anything.
You say he was acting strange?
Paul's always been very outgoing. Into everything, you know. And you couldn't shut him up.
And now?
He's either in there or he's out. Won't say where he's going, won't say where he's been. Ask him, you get your head bitten off.
Had a word with him about it.
Can't get through him. None of us can. Not even his sister, and they've always been close. I used to think he and I were, but... I don't recognise him anymore.
Mrs. Mitchell?
Yeah?
I'm PC Hollis. It's PC Loxton.
It's round the side.
When did it happen?
I don't know. We was at the hospital. My son, Danny, he took an overdose.
Kids, was it?
Four or five of them.
Mm-hmm. I understand we've got a witness.
Mrs. Mitchell phoned the school and told me about Danny. I decided I'd call in here on the way home and see how he was, if there was anything we could do.
I haven't got back yet.
As I arrived, I saw smoke coming from the side of the house. I came round and saw the door on fire and four or five lads climbing over the back fence. I tried to grab one of them and he turned round and kicked me in the face.
Did you recognise any of them?
I recognise the one that kicked me.
Right, first of all, I want to talk about the theft of an item of jewellery from Bryant's in the Cheetham Road shopping mall.
I did it. All right?
You admit stealing the jewellery?
and a wallet from the shop next door.
What's been going on?
How'd you do it?
I just hung around pretending I was looking at things. When the staff were looking the other way, I lifted them.
And what do you do with these items of jewellery afterwards? They weren't found on you.
I threw them away, into a bin.
When was this?
A few minutes after.
So you go to all that trouble of stealing things and then just chuck them away? There wasn't anybody else with you that you were passing them on to?
No, I was on my own.
I mean, you can see how my mind's working, can't you? One minute I'm at school asking you about Danny Mitchell. Next thing I know, you've been nicked for theft.
Paul, if there were other people with you, don't you protect them? The best thing you can do now is tell the truth.
That is the truth.
Your headmaster says the other kids look up to you. Does Danny look up to you? Is that how you got him involved?
I didn't. Look, I put my hands up to stealing those things from the shop, that's it.
Just you, on your own, for no reason at all. And whatever your mate Danny's been up to, pure coincidence. Don't make a lot of sense, does it? DC Lyons enters the room.
Can I have a word, Sarge? There
you go. Cheers.
Someone to see you.
Mr. Benskin, what's happened to you?
I went to Mrs. Mitchell's to see how Danny was and caught a group of lads setting fire to her door. Most of them weren't from my school, but the one who did this was.
Who was it?
One of the boys you talked to, the big lad, Steve McVeigh.
It's a bit heavy, isn't it, for a couple of school kids?
Just the one. It's the big blonde lad, Steve McVeigh.
What's he done then?
Ringing doorbells, crumping apples, the usual stuff.
Is he the one that did the head teacher?
Yeah. We don't let him get away. You go round the front.
Right. Got your vest on then, Reg?
Yeah, too right.
That'll keep you nice and warm.
Well, don't fancy getting stabbed in the chest.
Reg, they're likely to be carrying knives.
You two go in front.
Thanks, Sarge.
Everybody ready?
Ready.
Ready.
Okay, let's go. Steve, can I have a word?
Get off me!
We're gonna lose him!
No, we're not.
Who put that there?
We were just mucking about.
What, setting fire to someone's door?
We have a bit of a go at Danny sometimes, wind him up a bit.
And kicking Mr. Benskin in the face, was that wind up too?
That was an accident. I was just getting over the fence. He just got in the way.
He says you deliberately kicked him.
He's got a downer on me.
I'm showing the prisoner a brooch, a wallet and a credit card found on his person. Exhibits GD1, GD2 and GD3. The brooch and the wallet were stolen this afternoon in the Cheetham Road shopping mall.
Not by me, I bought them.
Who off?
A mate, Paul Gibson.
Did he say where he got them?
Didn't ask him.
What about the credit card, which was stolen from a man in Canberra Road on Wednesday? Who'd you buy that off?
No one, I found it.
Where?
Gateside Street. I was going to hand it in, though.
So according to you, the fire was a schoolboy prank, the assault was an accident, you bought the brooch and the wallet, and you found the credit card. Do you really think anyone's going to believe that?
It's the truth.
My money's on Gibson.
McVeigh's got the muscle.
Yeah, but he's thick, isn't he? Any combination involving him and Gibson, Gibson's got to be the brain.
So why does McVeigh end up with the loot?
Maybe his treasurer. Maybe his dad doesn't check his room periodically.
Yeah, from what I hear, his father's long gone.
Either way, it's down to Danny Mitchell now. He's the weak link.
Yeah.
Right. Let's start with a street robbery in Canberra Road at 5 o'clock on Wednesday evening.
I don't know anything about it.
The victim gave us a good description, Danny. You fit that description.
Where were you at the time?
Not there.
Where then?
I don't remember.
We found the victim's credit card in the possession of your mate, Steve McVeigh. How did he get hold of it? Is this why they set fire to your back door? As a warning to keep your mouth shut?
They can't get to you now. They're all in here. McVeigh, Paul Gibson.
Only you're the one in real trouble.
Oh, Danny, tell him the truth.
I am.
You know what happens next? We put you in a lineup, and if the victims pick you out, that's it. You're in it up to here.
Danny!
You can cover for them if you want, Danny. But they'll walk away laughing.
I didn't want to do it.
Do what?
The muggins. They made me.
Is that why they beat you up today? Because you made a mess of it?
I did it on purpose.
I didn't get a chance the other two times. This time I thought they couldn't see. I sort of told her to run for it.
Who are they?
Steve McVeigh and his mates. They gave me the knife and told me who to go for. Then they hid somewhere and watched.
Oh, my God.
I had to! They know where we live!
You're saying Steve McVeigh made threats against you unless you carried out the robberies?
He said he'd use the knife on me. He wasn't kidding.
What about Paul Gibson? What was his part in all this?
He's not one of them. He tried to stop him. But if he couldn't stand up to him, what chance did I have?
Yeah, well, of course, I can still remember the bully at my school. He had dirty great fists. I can still feel his knuckles round the back of my head.
Didn't happen to me.
Ah, well, more of a boy's thing, isn't it?
Don't you believe it?
Happens to everyone. It's part of growing up.
So what was it like at your school?
Don't remember.
He must have had a school bully.
Steve probably was a school bully.
It was. It was him, wasn't it?
No, it wasn't.
I bet you helped him out when he had a day off, though.
Just leave it, Reg.
Oh, why? What are you going to do? Spit on their sandwiches?
Steve McVeigh used to hang around with some older lads. They did a few muggings.
You know the names?
They weren't from our school. We never saw them, but he was always going on about them. Anyway, a couple of them got caught. So he lay low for a bit. That's when he started picking on Danny.
Why him?
Everyone picks on Danny. McVeigh was trying to make him do stuff. Robberies. I reckon he thought it was getting too risky to do it himself. I reckon he thought it was funny, too. Danny of all people. Danny told me about it.
What did you do?
I told McVeigh to lay off him. That's when he started picking on me. Him and a couple of these lads were waiting for me on the way home one night. They had knives. McVeigh wanted me to steal stuff from shops.
And he threatened you with violence if you didn't?
Yeah. I always gave the stuff straight to them. I never kept anything.
How many of these thefts did you commit?
Hang on a minute. What's my son's position here?
If Paul did these thefts under the threat of violence, there could be mitigating circumstances. In any case, it's in his best interest to tell the truth.
That is the truth! He threatened me. And my sister.
Your sister?
He said they'd rape her.
What? Why didn't you tell me? I could have sorted this.
You can't be there all the time, Dad. And I get embarrassed, then?
You must be joking. Your mother's washed her hands of you.
I'll inquire about accommodation.
Well, there wasn't any an hour ago for one of our other clients.
Looks like it'll be here, then.
I'll see you around.
Where? He's going home. You're going in there.
Show Miss McVeigh to his room, will you?
I'll see if I can talk the mother around and get him out of here.
If you ask me, this is the best place for him.
Well, I gather there's been a lot of trouble in that family. The father's not on the scene anymore, but when he was, he used to beat him.
Probably in self-defence.
At my last school, I had two stabbings, a rape, and one parent threatened me with an axe. But I turned it round in the end. I'll do the same here.
Good luck.